This video will show you how to test a DUT with the N3300A electronic load at very low voltage. In this video, we're going to use the boost power supply shown here, and our device under test will be the 6623A. And to test a DUT at low voltage, what we're going to have to do is connect the boost power supply in series with the device under test and set 2 volts on the boost power supply. One of the requirements of using a boost power supply is that you have to make sure that the current rating of the boost power supply is the same as the device under test. In this video, we're using the N6700 power supply as the boost power supply, and our device under test is the 6623A. So right now, let's go over the setup. On our device under test, which is the 6623A, the voltage is set to 75 millivolts, and the current is set to approximately 5 amps. Now, moving down to our boost power supply, our voltage is set for 2 volts, and our current is set for 5 amps. And the one thing to remember here is that you have to make sure that the current limit on the device under test and on the boost power supply are exactly the same for safety reasons. Next, on the electronic load, we have our current set to pull 1 amp on the device under test. Currently, the whole system is stable. We have the boost power supply set to 2 volts. As you can see on the electronic load, it's pulling 1 amp from the DUT, as it should be. So now let's set the voltage of the boost power supply to 0 volts and see what happens. As you can see, the electronic load is no longer pulling 1 amp as it's programmed to, and it enters into an unregulated state at 0.7 amps. And this is what happens when the boost power supply is taken out of the equation in a low voltage operation using the electronic load. And once we put that 2 volts back into the boost power supply, you'll see that the 1 amp comes back up. And that's a brief overview of using a boost power supply with an N3300 electronic load in a low voltage operation.